plateau, and the isolated trees threw vague shadows that easily ran into a length of half a kilometer. Rapidly they spread, assuming monstrous shapes, half animal, half human, then, deceiving the sight, merged into the strange uniform glow that lies upon a snowfield in the twilight. The forest turned purple, the crests of the pines cut into the sky like things of steel and silver. Everything shone, crackled, sparkled. The cold increased.
"Dorothy, where are you going?"
sounded the older man's voice from the door, for the girl was out on her skis again. Her slim young figure, topped by the pointed white snow cap, was sprite-like.
"Just a little way over the slopes, to meet him,"
came her reply. She seemed to float above the snow, not on it. With decision, he called her in, and it was the warning in his tone that perhaps made her obey.
"Better rest," he said briefly. "We've got a long run home in the moonlight."
On her skis, she came sishing back down the gleaming slope to his side, neat and graceful, her shadow shooting ahead like black lightning, enormously elongated.
"The Creux de Van Precipices, besides, lie over that way,"
he continued.
"They begin without warning, a sheer drop, and nothing to show the edge."
"I know them,"
she said, pouting a little.
"He knows them too,"
her uncle answered, putting a hand on her shoulder.
"He'll take the higher slopes. He'll get around all right."
He had noticed a look in her soft, brown eyes that betrayed. It was the merest passing lash, an eagerness lying too close upon the verge of anxiety.
"Harry knows these ridges even better than I do."
He helped her stack the skis, then turned to whistle in the dog, which had stayed behind on the summit of the slope she had just left. And it was at this instant, I think, that I first suddenly became aware of an unusual significance lying behind the little scene. Such moments are beyond explanation or analysis. One can only report them. They pertain, some hold, to a kind of vision. I can merely affirm that the flash came to me in this wise. I saw the big dog, his outline sharply silhouetted against the skyline and his head turned westward, refusing, for the first time that day, to obey instantly a whistle that